Today we're going to learn how to install the RepRap Discount Smart Controller on the Bigtree Tech SKR version 1.0. Now, as you can see on this actual display, you can click on the potentiometer and hold it down to turn, or just click once and turn. We also have a piezo buzzer underneath here that's covered with a little bit of tape. We also have a stop button, which is also used as a reset. On the back side, we have EXP 1 and 2, and then we have our SD card reader, as well as our potentiometer to adjust contrast. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to show you on Marlin's website where our EXP ports are for the pinout diagram. So I'm going to go over to my browser for a moment. And I'm going to show you over here that we have EXP2 and EXP1. So those are the ports that we're actually going to be using. So if we go back over to our workbench here, we can actually pick this up, go to EXP1 and plug this in, then take the other end of the notched connector and plug it in as well over here. Then we'll do the same for EXP2. And then we'll plug in the notch connector as well over here. So I'm going to place this back down. And in order to test this to make sure it's working, we want to see if it lights up. So right now we're on PSU power for the power supply unit. So in order to use the USB to connect to this, we need to move this jumper over so we can power it to test it. When we're printing, we actually want to move this back when we're using PSU power. So I'm going to plug this in and see if it lights up. And it does. So we know that it's working. So the next thing that we want to do is actually load the firmware. So I have this little USB converter drive that I'm going to use to connect with the SD card as a USB. So I'm going to plug it in here. And just so you know, I'm going to place an affiliate link in the description for these things so you can find them. And no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. So I'm going to plug this into the computer. And then I'm going to go over to VS Code. And inside VS Code, what I'm going to do is actually, let me pull it up here real quick. So inside VS Code, we're going to actually load the firmware. So I'm going to click on the Explorer, then open folder, then I'm going to go to my downloads folder, my Marlin 2.0, then my Marlin 2.0, both, or just so you understand, I actually extracted this after I downloaded it. So then I'm going to say select folder, and this will bring up the actual configuration for Marlin as its default. So to configure this, what I'm going to actually do is go to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm gonna do a search on SKR, and this should bring us right to our board down here, but we don't see it right away, so we'll just say the pro with an underscore between SKR. And as you can see, here is our board. So we're gonna copy this. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. We're going to minimize core and source and go to configuration.h. Now we'll search on motherboard here and find it. We'll highlight the RAMP's default configuration for the board and paste over it. Then we'll change our serial port up here to -1. That's so that we can connect via USB for other things. And then what we'll do to actually configure the LCD is as follows. So we'll search on SD space support, and this will bring us to LCD and SD support. Now, if you don't know already, you can do multiple languages. They have a test language if you want to change it to a language that's more in line with what you speak or write. But as you can see, there's RU for Ruska or Russian. Then we have, what is it, DE for Deutschland, which is German. And of course, we have like PL for Polska or Polish. But you'll put the two-letter abbreviation right here in order to select your language, unless it's the test language or this one right here, which I'm not sure what the language is, but we could probably scroll over and find out what it is. So it's traditional Chinese. So they're all listed right here for your convenience. Then if we scroll down, you can see there's other things that we can set. Now, there's obviously an option for Cyrillic, for something like Russian. There's Western, and then there's Japanese. For now, we're going to leave this alone because we don't need to worry about it. But there are different types of LCD displays that you can set up. Right now, it's default to classic. But this stuff about the speed is something specialized, so we're going to avoid that for the moment. You can look that up on your own. But what we're interested in is actually the SD support up here. So we're going to actually remove the comment so we can use SD support. Now there is an option for SD check and retry, but at the moment we're not going to worry about that. There may be an issue with this board that they're fixing in possibly the next build, or it may already be fixed. We'll find out in a moment. But there's other things for different types of menuing that you can have. I'm going to skip over a lot of this because you can read about this on your own and set it up to your liking. So the next thing that we need to do is actually find the LCD we're using. So we're going to do a find, and we're going to look for rep wrap underscore discount. And this will bring us to the first option right here. This is actually our display, so we're going to remove the comment to enable it. And then we need to set up the build so that we can actually use it. So I'm going to click on platformio.ini. And as you can see, the default environment is for the Mega 2560 chipset, which we need to change because we're not using that. So we're going to search on SKR underscore pro, and that'll bring us to our default environment. So we'll copy that, and then we'll scroll all the way to the top, highlight the Mega 2560, and paste it over that. Now, if you do other builds like myself, I like to do a clean before I actually do a build. That'll clean out your .pio folder of any builds. So after that's complete, what we need to then do is click on the checkbox to build our actual configuration. So this is going to take a few seconds. While this is going, I'll show you the drive. Here's the drive with the current firmware for the SD card. And I'll bring it up so you can see it here. And it says firmware.cur. That's the current firmware that we're working with. Keep in mind, there might be a bug where it'll only read the actual firmware off here for the excuse me, for the G codes. I'm not gonna actually show you that. I'll just tell you about it, that it may default to this drive, in which case you can pop it out and see if the other drive works. Otherwise, there may be a fix in the nightly build or bug fix for this. So I'm gonna close this, and I'm gonna go over to .pio for a moment. Then I'm gonna go to build. Then I'm gonna go to the SKR folder, and I'm gonna find our firmware.bin, which is our binary. So I'm gonna right click on that, and I'm gonna go to show or reveal in Explorer. Here I'm gonna right click, and I'm going to send it to our D drive. So we can verify it's there, and this will be converted into this if it loads properly. So I'm gonna go back over to the desktop for a moment, and I'm gonna show you how to install this. So I'm gonna pop out the drive right here. I'm gonna place the SD card in here, and then I'm gonna power it. So this should come up as the RepRap Discount Smart Controller if things work out correctly, which it does. So it's for Marlin, pardon me. So if you want to select an actual file, this may not work, but we'll give it a try. So I'm going to take an SD card that I have right here, and I'm going to place it in here. So there was an existing bug that I was talking about. I want to see if it actually exists still. So it says media is inserted. So I'm going to click, and then I'm going to turn to print from media. So it looks like they did fix it, but keep in mind if you have media for a G code on your SD drive, this may cause an issue where it reads this first. The solution to that, if that is the case, is you can pop out this, then release this or take it out, and then power this back up, and it should work fine. So let's take a look. So if we click here and we scroll down to print media, it's still there. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.